Data-driven texture modeling and rendering has greatly pushed the limit of realism in haptics. The data-driven method starts with the signal recording from the interaction with real textures, and then creates mathematical models for the texture using the recorded signals. Recent methods focus on the modeling of texture characters such as friction and microscopic surface features based on the recorded user's interactive motions and high-frequency vibrotactile signals. But there are still several limitations in the current data-driven method. First, when we are facing the countless textures in the world, the recording process is expensive in terms of devices and the time. Second, we cannot eliminate the perception mismatch from the textual recording to the textual rendering due to their fundamentally different actuation methods. Third, it is hard to interpret and extrapolate the current haptic textual models for generating new virtual textures. So, in this work, we aim at enabling the users to interactively generate and search a virtual texture for an unmodeled real textures based on their preferences during the interaction with a set of virtual texture candidates. The system consists of two important building blocks. The first is a deep convolutional generative adversarial network for mapping the latent vectors into texture models, which are trained on UPenn Haptic Texture Toolkit. The second is a comparison-based evolution algorithm, covariance matrix adaptation evolution strategy for creating a new texture model that involves given guidance from the user's preferred feedback within a set of generated texture models. The procedures are as follows. To model a real texture, we first ask a user to touch the real texture using a customized tool, and then touch a set of virtual texture candidates using a haptic device, where the haptic feedback is transmitted through a haptuator attached to the stylus of the device. Based on the feeling during the touch, the user will select one virtual texture which they think closest to the real texture. Then, all three virtual textures will be updated based on the user's selection following an evolution strategy. After the update, the user will try virtual texture candidates again and then select the texture they think closest to the real one. During this process, the user can adjust the friction of the texture using a slider at any time to match the perceived resistance from the real texture. In addition, the user can go back to try the real texture as well. Once the user finds a virtual texture close enough to the real texture, they can save it and continue the search. The user repeats this process until they don't think they can find a closer virtual texture. Under this framework, there is no recording step, and the texture modeling process follows the guidance from the user's preferred feedback within a set of generated texture models when comparing to the real texture. So, we call it preference-driven. In contrast to data-driven methods which try to mimic and regenerate the recorded signal, the preference-driven method uses users' preferences to guide the modeling process. For the evaluation of the preference-driven textures, we separated the study into two phases with two separate groups of participants. In phase 1, 5 participants individually generated and searched the virtual textures for 5 real textures using our preference-driven texture modeling method. The final saved the preference-driven textures with their corresponding real textures and the data-driven textures were used and evaluated in phase 2. In phase 2, we conducted objective ratings based on the perceptual dimensions of roughness, hardness, and slipperiness, and the similarity comparison of real versus preference-driven textures and the real versus data-driven textures. The results show that by comparing the feel of real and generated virtual textures, users can efficiently find a virtual texture model that matched or exceeded the realism of a data-driven model following an evolutionary process. In addition, for 4 out of 5 real textures, greater than 80% of the preference-driven models from participants are rated comparable to the data-driven models. In conclusion, this work presents an interactive texture generation and search framework driven by users' preferences, called preference-driven texture modeling. For the increasingly popular pen-based digital design, we hope this work can give users more flexibility in the texture modeling.